Let's get in a party colleague of the Prime Minister of India. Sudhanshu Mittal is with us. Mr. Mittal, what is your government trying to achieve? Do you want to scare Pakistan? Do you want to engage Pakistan? Do you want to just send out strong signals and see where it goes?
I'll first quickly respond to General Abbas. General Abbas was saying India does not realize what the people of Pakistan are facing. General Sahab, pearls of wisdom are you reap what you sow. You create Frankenstein's monsters, naturally they're going to eat you. You support terrorism and the same people are then going to kill you. That's the historical fact which you must understand and now at least become wise. You talked about Mr. Modi's statement in Bangladesh. What was the context? He says India should have a permanent place in Security Council. Our track record is such. Even when we had 90,000 prisoners of Pakistan, where today even people holding 10 people are bargaining, we peacefully returned that. That is all what he said. And look, what is the response of your government? Now, unfortunate part of Pakistan is you have an insecure prime minister and a deposed general who's facing charge of murder. They want to cater to their own personal constituencies within Pakistan. So the more strident they are about anti-Indian rhetorics, the more chances there are that they may have wider acceptability. We have not named you. We have fought terrorists in Northeast. What is your reason for being provoked? Because you are seeing that the government of India now is determined to really fight the menace of terrorism, which every government should do. Because in a civilized society, there cannot be room for violence and terrorism. So what do? Your Senate, can you imagine? Your Senate is passing a resolution. What has the Indian government said about you? Nothing. Even the minister, you are saying minister has not talked about Pakistan. He says countries which are patronizing terrorism. Allow me, sir.
Mr. Rathore named Pakistan, sir.
Hasn't Mr. Rathore named Pakistan?
I have seen the statement. Let us assume he did. The historical fact is that you have Dawood there, you have Asad Masood there, you have all kind of undesirable elements who have been perpetrating violence in India. That is a historical fact, and that is also the stand which India government has taken fair and square. And what did it say? He says, this is what you are doing, which you should not do, you should desist. So for that, a minister here says you have the entire Senate passing. Because you see, you would have reacted otherwise also. Whether it was Mr. Rathore's statement or any statement, you would have reacted. Because the core issue is not what is said. The core issue is that the government of India has decided enough is enough. We will fight terrorism with all our might, with all our energy at our command. And the nation is united on that. Please understand this. We don't
and
have
so
a quality which is divided. Allow me, sir. Sir,
we
you are not doing the same. Out of your frustration of our action against terrorists, you are now reacting and look at your reaction.
Right.
It is most laughable that your Senate is passing
war?
A resolution.
Let's get General
about
Abbas
what?
To respond. Sir,
Senate
this was an army operation in response to a militant attack in Manipur. Why has this become an India-Pakistan issue?
Because the Pakistan was named by your own government minister. He has named
sir,
Pakistan.
About,
he has
you
given
talked about
a threat
Mr.
to
Modi's
Pakistan.
Statement in,
it is coming, it is coming
the
from a higher government official. What do you expect Pakistan to respond? To remain quiet when Pakistan is being named and threatened by your higher government official? What do you expect from Pakistan? Look,
sir,
Pakistan
what was objectionable about Mr. Modi's statement? What was objectionable about Mr. Modi's statement in Bangladesh? Tell me that. What did he say which you are quite hurt about?
He takes pride in interfering in the internal affair of another country and getting it liberated. This is his statement. He says Pakistan is a nuisance in Dhaka
sir,
University.
Your general says 1947 Kashmir is an unresolved issue. Your historicity
is
justified.
It is.
Whereas the Prime Minister is talking about how peace loving we are.
It is still on the UN agenda, and we want the UN to resolve it. We want the UN to resolve it. This is what the Prime Minister says.
Let me get in the others here as well.
At least be logical.
Okay, let me get in.
I don't think it is. You know, just one line.
Yeah.
The problem of the compulsion of domestic politics of Pakistan we are overlooking. You see, the last election was the only election where Kashmir was not the central theme of the election.
Hmm.
Otherwise, ever since there have been elections in Pakistan, Kashmir has occupied the central space. The more strident you are, the better chances you had of succeeding. Unfortunately, the same mindset is now returning back.
But what about India's position, Mr. Mittal? What about India's position?
Just one liner. When you say the Kashmir wasn't a central focal point during the election, so was India not a focal point relation. Rather, there was an atmosphere of friendly relations with India. This is what Nawaz Sharif and Pakistan Muslim League Noon have won the election on improving relations with India. But look at the BJP stance. What was the rhetorics? What were the election rhetorics in India?
General Saab, BJP's election rhetorics was development and not Pakistan, because you have to understand, Pakistan does not occupy the mind space of Indians. The Indian population is looking for development. It is not looking back at Pakistan. So you do not occupy
then
other mind space.
Such a high,
your
why
problem,
Mr. Mittal, I want to ask a question. Mr. Mittal, right. What was the need to boast about a covert operation?
There is a change in strategy which India is now pursuing. It's a matter of national pride for all of us that as a country we have decided to pursue things to logical end when it comes to terrorism, which is fair. And why should we talk about it? Why should we talk about the resolve? Now, I just want to respond to General Saab's this thing. General Saab, thank you for this mercy of leaving us out in your election. Unfortunate part is we made a gesture of requesting Nawaz Sharif Saab and we wanted to continue with dialogue. Look at your response to that. When the dialogue at the level of the secretaries is starting, you call the Huriyat, which is completely unacceptable to anybody. So your intent
wasn't Huriyat given visa for Pakistan. Wasn't Huriyat leaders given visa for Pakistan? Sir, can I?
It is none of your business whom we give visa to. That's our internal matter. But you are fermenting problems by on one side talking about peace and talking about good relations and deliberately provoking the Indian government. What did we do? We said, okay, if that is your mindset, we are not interested in talking to you. Fair deal. You are missing an historical opportunity of improving relations with Pakistan. Why has cross-border firing decreased now? Because of the response I just now told to you. Because we decided enough is enough. We have been trying to be friendly to you, but if you take a hostile posture towards India, so be it. And that is it.
Make no mistake, Pakistan is not Myanmar.
Sir, you have also
you want to try that?
That you cannot take India for granted. You have to understand that covert operations in India or having and firing not, at borders is a thing of past. It is no more possible for you. You have to understand that the response of the Indian government would be proportionate to what you are doing. You are not going to
the
get
the patience
get
shown by Pakistani government and army should not be misinterpreted. Should not be misinterpreted,
sir,
Pakistan
sir,
government and army's patience. And make no mistake, Pakistan is not Myanmar. Okay?
Sir, make no mistake that the resolution of the Senate speaks volumes of your nervousness about what India is doing. Otherwise,
that is people of Pakistan feel like
about,
that. If Senate sir, conveys,
sir,
that is the sentiment of the public.
It is the sentiment of the public. It is a pure signal of nervousness. It is, see, you have a general talking about nuclear war. You have a
Senate reflects
Senate,
a public,
a Senate,
that's
imagine,
a public sentiment.
Imagine an
the
Indian
Senate
government, Indian
you
parliament.
To,
sir, it is.
You want
sir,
to disregard
Senate,
the public sentiment
imagine,
of Pakistan? Do that.
Sir, public is not.
If you want to disregard
the
public.
Of Pakistan.
So, what is the Senate?
Sir,
what
is
Senate representative public?
Okay, let me.
Isn't Senate representing
public?
Let me get it, General Hasnain here. General Hasnain, when the government of India
has been
when the government of India repeatedly says,
don't camouflage public sentiment for the benefit of your ISI and your army.
Okay.
Your army game and your ISI game is very different than what the public of Pakistan wants. You, because you want to continue with your hegemony of having your political establishment, so you are doing this. We all know that. the response of the Pakistan Senate in passing the resolution is laughable.
Right.
I mean,
Mr. Mittal, let me get in the other panelists here. General Hasnain, when the government of India